basically, long and short of it is, me and Dan have always been interested in this kind of like idea of almost like a demi-themed album, which is kind of like, it's themed around the same ideas and like a central theme, but the songs themselves aren't exactly a concept. So we don't go, you know, Coheed and Cambria into it, don't go demi-bourgeois into it, it's like more like the idea of the thing. And this will probably be our last one, but because of that, when me and Dan sat down and we thought about how we wanted to do it, Dan came up with runes, and like in Norse mythology, like they were used in order for divination and to see the future and to look at the past and stuff like that. So we thought it'd be a really good way of almost like bringing back the themes that we talked about in Portraits and bringing back the themes that we talked about in Union of Crowns, and also exploring new ones, but kind of do it almost, if you will, if it was like this one big concept.
The best way to write about 10 years in one album.
Yeah, like, because you're able to look backwards and also look forwards, and so that's where we've drawn the themes from. But again, Dan's also brought out new themes that we want to hint at where we're going as well, particularly, you know, back to what we were saying about the riffs, like, you know, that they're just as important as the lyrics in showing where we're heading. We've gone back to some songs on the new record are reminiscent of the style that we wrote on Portraits, some are reminiscent of the style on Union of Crowns, but the majority of them are showing where we want to go, where we want to push forward to. And I think both lyrically and musically, it's almost like both nostalgic and futuristic at the same time. It and that's the whole point of Runes, that's, you know, so it all ties together with the theme. We don't think about the vocalists initially, being a band that is more metal than metalcore. Like, we always write our music first, and we want the riffs and the structure of the song to be at a point that even if you didn't have any vocals on it, you could show someone who was into metal and be like, yeah, that's a wicked
song.
Yeah,
we definitely write the songs without vocals on first, and then it's just we're a riff mainly riff based band, aren't we? Just riff and riff and riff, and then we've got enough riffs.
We've got a riff.
We can't riff anymore. then it normally doesn't take us that long to put together the songs, and then
like the music gets put together, and then Dan and Jay sit down, discuss the themes around the song and how we're going about it, and then write the lyrics accordingly, and then we just listen to some more riffs.
Yeah, it's all riffs, really.
Essentially just riffs.
You listen to us on CD and we probably sound like we care about vocals, but
we care more about riffs.
Really, it's just the riff. The riff's the main thing.
What about the beats?
Nah, fuck the beats. Yeah. Like, the beats, you know, sorry Jacko, but fuck the beats. It's all about the riffs. Like, you can take the drums out and the riffs are still heavy on this album. Mm. So like, you don't even need the drum, you don't need the vocals, you don't need the drum, you don't even need me, you don't need the bass. Just listen to the riffs. Guitars. That's just guitars, riffs.
I'd listen to our album with just guitars.
Yeah. We're gonna do a deluxe release of this one that is just the riff release. That is just instrumental riffs, I mean, the whole way through.
Amazing. 10 or 15 riffs that didn't make it onto the record.
Yeah.
There'll be
bonus riffs.
Yeah, bonus riffs.